This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. In grammar, the voice, also called diathesis and rarely gender of verbs of a verb, describes the relationship between the action or state that the verb expresses and the participants identified by its arguments, subject, object, etc. When the subject is the agent or doer of the action, the verb is in the active voice. When the subject is the patient, target or undergoer of the action, the verb is said to be in the passive voice. For example, in the sentence, "the cat ate the mouse," the verb "ate" is in the active voice. However, in the sentence, "the mouse was eaten by the cat," the verb phrase "was eaten" is passive. In the sentence, "the hunter killed the bear," the verb "killed" is in the active voice, and the doer of the action is the hunter. A passive version of the sentence is "the bear was killed by the hunter," where the verbal phrase "was killed" is followed by the word "by" and then by the doer "hunter." In a transformation from an active voice clause to an equivalent passive voice construction, the subject and the direct object switch grammatical roles. The direct object gets promoted to subject, and the subject demoted to an optional complement. In the examples above, the mouse serves as the direct object in the active voice version, but becomes the subject in the passive version. The subject of the active voice version, the cat, becomes part of a prepositional phrase in the passive version of the sentence, and can be left out entirely. Contents 1. History 2. Active 3. Passive 4. Middle 5. Others 6. Passive in topic. Prominent languages 7. Fourth person in Finnic languages 8. Impersonal in Celtic languages 9. Dynamic and static passive 91. German 92. English 93. Swedish 94. Spanish 95. Italian 96. Venetian 10. List 11. See also 12. Notes 13. References. History. In the traditional grammar of ancient Greek, voice was called diathesis. Diathesis, arrangement or condition, with three subcategories: active energia, passive pathos, and middle mesotes. In Latin there are two voices, active and passive. Latin, activum, passivum. Active. Further information: active voice. The active voice is the most commonly used in many languages and represents the normal case, in which the subject of the verb is the agent in the active voice. The subject of the sentence performs the action or causes the happening denoted by the verb. Examples of active voice include the following: Kabaisa ate the potatoes. The verb ate indicates the active voice, but consider the following sentence, which is in passive voice: the potatoes were eaten by Kabaisa. The verb were eaten indicates the presence of passive voice. The active voice sentence shows that someone has done something or has caused something to happen, whereas the passive voice sentence shows that something has been acted upon by someone else. Passive. Further information: passive voice. English passive voice. The passive voice is employed in a clause whose subject expresses the theme or patient of the verb, that is, it undergoes an action or has its state changed. In the passive voice, the grammatical subject of the verb is the recipient, not the doer of the action denoted by the verb. Some languages, such as English and Spanish, use a periphrastic passive voice, that is, it is not a single word form, but rather a construction making use of other word forms. Specifically, it is made up of a form of the auxiliary verb to be and a past participle of the main verb. In other languages, such as Latin, the passive voice is simply marked on the verb by inflection. Librum legit, he reads the book. Librum legator, the book is read. Middle. Further information: deponent verb, reflexive verb, mediopassive voice and unaccusative verb. Some languages such as Albanian, Bengali, Fula, Tamil, Sanskrit, Icelandic, Swedish, Biblical Hebrew and Ancient Greek have a middle voice, which is a set of inflections or constructions which is to some extent different from both the active and passive voices. The middle voice is said to be in the middle between the active and the passive voices because the subject often cannot be categorized as either agent or patient but may have elements of both. For example, it may express what would be an intransitive verb in English in the casserole cooked in the oven. Cooked is syntactically active but semantically passive in classical Greek. The middle voice often has a reflexive sense. The subject acts on or for itself, such as "the boy washes himself," or "the boy washes." It can be transitive or intransitive. It can occasionally be used in a causative sense, such as "the father causes his son to be set free," or "the father ransoms his son." In English there is no verb form for the middle voice, though some uses may be classified as middle voice, often resolved via a reflexive pronoun, as in "Fred shaved," which may be expanded to "Fred shaved himself," contrast with active "Fred shaved John," or passive "John was shaved by Fred." This need not be reflexive, as in "My clothes soaked in detergent overnight." English used to have a distinct form, called the passival, which was displaced over the early 19th century by the passive progressive progressive passive, and is no longer used in English in the passival. One would say "the house is building," which is today instead. The house is being built, likewise, the meal is eating, which is now, the meal is being eaten. Note that the similar, Fred is shaving, and, the clothes are soaking, remain grammatical. It is suggested that the progressive passive was popularized by the Romantic poets, and is connected with Bristol usage. Many deponent verbs in Latin are survivals of the Proto-Indo-European middle voice, citation needed. Others, some languages have even more grammatical voices. For example, Classical Mongolian features five voices, active, passive, causative, reciprocal, and cooperative. Hebrew has active, passive, causative, intensive and reflexive voices. The antipassive voice deletes or demotes the object of transitive verbs, and promotes the actor to an intransitive subject. This voice is very common among ergative absolutive languages, which may feature passive voices as well, but also occurs among nominative accusative languages. There are also constructions in some languages that appear to change the valence of a verb, but in fact do not. So-called hierarchical or inversion languages are of this sort. Their agreement system will be sensitive to an external person or animacy hierarchy, or a combination of both. 1. Verbs inflect for both subject and object, but agreement markers do not have inherent values for these. Rather, a third marker, the direct or inverse marker, indicates the proper interpretation. Ne wa, pam e, wa, I am looking at him, but ne wa, pam e k w w a, he is looking at me. Some scholars, notably Rhodes, have analyzed this as a kind of obligatory passivization dependent on animacy, while others have claimed it is not a voice at all, but rather see inversion as another type of alignment, parallel to nominative accusative, ergative absolutive, split s, and fluid s alignments. Passive in topic prominent languages. Topic prominent languages like Mandarin tend not to employ the passive voice as frequently. Mandarin speakers construct the passive voice by using the cover bei bei and rearranging the usual word order. For example, this sentence using active voice. Note, the first line is in traditional Chinese while the second is simplified Chinese. Go yao la jie gi nan ren go yao la. Jie gi nan ren go yao la zhej nan ren dog bite perfect. This man, a dog has bitten this man, corresponds to the following sentence using passive voice. Note that the agent phrase is optional. Jie gi nan ren bei go yao la. Jie gi nan ren bei go yao la zhej nan ren bei go yao la. This man bei dog bite perfect. This man has been bitten by a dog. In addition, through the addition of the auxiliary verb to be, she, the passive voice is frequently used to emphasize the identity of the actor. This example places emphasis on the dog. Presumably as opposed to some other animal, jie gi nan ren shi bei go yao la. Jie gi nan ren shi bei go yao la zhej nan ren shi bei go yao la. This man to be bei dog bite perfect. This man has been bitten by a dog. Although a topic prominent language, Japanese employs the passive voice quite frequently, and has two types of passive voice, one that corresponds to that in English and an indirect passive not found in English. This indirect passive is used when something undesirable happens to the speaker by ha ni bang ni kai bu wo. Dao Marita Care Wa Dorobo Ni Saifu O Nusumarita He. Topic thief agent wallet object steal passive past, his wallet was stolen by a thief. Pu Bainu Ni Shu Wo Sukarita Boku Wa Kanojo Ni Uso O Sukarita I. Topic her agent lie object. Tell passive past, I was lied to by her, or, she lied to me. Fourth person in Finnic languages. Some languages do not contrast voices, but have other similar constructions. For example, Finnic languages such as Finnish and Estonian have a passive, expressed by conjugating the verb in common person. Although it is generally referred to as the passive passivi in Finnish grammars, it may more appropriately be referred to as the fourth person form of a verb. The function of the fourth person is simply to leave out the agent. The agent is almost always human and never mentioned. The grammatical role of the object remains unaltered, and thus transitivity may also be used. For example, the fourth person construction akuna hahodatan, with a transitive verb, means someone broke the window, while the third person construction akuna hajosi uses the anticausative and means the window broke. Impersonal in Celtic languages. Celtic languages have an inflection commonly called the impersonal or autonomous form, of similar origin to the Latin passive impersonal. This is similar to a passive construction in that the agent of the verb is not specified. However, its syntax is different from prototypical passives, in that the object of the action remains in the Accusative, it is similar to the use of the pronoun on in French. It increasingly corresponds to the passive in modern English, in which there is a trend towards avoiding the use of the passive unless it is specifically required to omit the subject. It also appears to be similar to the fourth person mentioned in the preceding paragraph. However, what is called an Irish and Briathar saor or the free verb does not suggest passivity but a kind of generalized agency. The construction has equal validity in transitive and intransitive clauses, and the best translation into English is normally by using the dummy subjects they, one, or impersonal you. For example, the common sign against tobacco consumption has its closest direct translation in English as no smoking. Na kadir tabak. Don't use impersonal tobacco. An example of its use as an intransitive is tayathir. Go dieti and sradwala. Go minich desatheran. Go impersonal to the village, often Saturday. People often go to the village of a Saturday. The difference between the autonomous and a true passive is that while the autonomous focuses on the action and overtly avoids mentioning the actor, there is nonetheless an anonymous agent who may be referred to in the sentence. For instance, taiti agith bail la shile go. Eat meal with each other. People used to go eating a meal together in English. The formation of the passive allows the optional inclusion of an agent in a prepositional phrase, by the man, etc., where English would leave out the noun phrase. Irish uses the autonomous, where English includes the noun phrase. Irish uses its periphrastic passive, which can also leave out the noun phrase. The tobacco was smoked by the man B and tabak kadi agan bh fear was. The tobacco consumed by the man. The impersonal endings have been re-analyzed as a passive voice in modern Welsh, and the agent can be included after the preposition gone by. Sanir y gan gan y cor. The song is sung by the choir. Dynamic and static passive. Some linguists draw a distinction between static or stative passive voice and dynamic or eventive passive voice in some languages. Examples include English, German, Swedish, Spanish and Italian. Static means that an action was done to the subject at a certain point in time, resulting in a state in the time focused upon, whereas dynamic means that an action takes place. German static passive auxiliary verb, sign dynamic passive auxiliary verb, worden der Rasen ist gemäht, the lawn is mown, static der Rasen wird gemäht, the lawn is being mown, literally, the lawn becomes mown, dynamic. English static passive auxiliary verb, be the, be passive, dynamic passive auxiliary verb, get the, get passive. Note that for some speakers of English this is not accepted and is considered colloquial or sub-standard. The grass is cut, static the grass gets cut or the grass is being cut. Dynamic Swedish static passive auxiliary verb, vara ar, var, verit. Dynamic passive auxiliary verb, bli blir, blev, blivit. Dynamic passive in Swedish is also frequently expressed with the s ending. Doran r op. The door has been opened. Doran blir opnat. The door is being opened. The vara passive is often synonymous with, and sometimes preferable to, simply using the corresponding adjective. Doran ar open. The door is open. The bli passive is often synonymous with, and sometimes preferable to, the s passive. Doran opnas. The door is opening. Spanish. Spanish has two verbs corresponding to English to be, eser and estar. Eser is used to form the ordinary dynamic passive voice. La puerta es abierta. The door is opened. La puerta es cerrada. The door is closed. Note that this construction is very unidiomatic. In this case the usual phrasing would be la puerta se cierra. Estar is used to form what might be termed a static passive voice, not regarded as a passive voice in traditional Spanish grammar. La puerta está abierta. The door is open. I.e. it has been opened. La puerta está cerrada. The door is closed. I.e. it has been closed. In both cases, the verb's participle is used as the complement, as is sometimes the case in English. Italian. Italian uses two verbs, essere and venire, to translate the static and the dynamic passive. Dynamic passive auxiliary verb, essere and venire, to be and to come. La porta è aperta or la porta viene aperta. The door is opened or the door comes open. La porta è chiusa or la porta viene chiusa. The door is closed or the door comes closed. Static passive auxiliary verb, essere, to be. La porta è aperta. The door is open, i.e. it has been opened. La porta è chiusa. The door is closed, i.e. it has been closed. Venetian in Venetian veneto. The difference between dynamic true passive and stative adjectival passive is more clear-cut, using essere to be only for the static passives and vegnere to to become, to come only for the dynamic passive, la porta la viene verta, the door is opened, dynamic la porta la zi, lei verta, the door is open, static forms represents much more a property or general condition, whereas the dynamic form is a real passive action entailing, by someone, esser protetto, to be protected equals to be in a safe condition, static vegner protetto, to be protected equals to be defended by so, dynamic esser considera, to be considered equals to have a good reputation, static Wegner considera to be taken into consideration by people, by so, dynamic esser representa alanu to be represented at the UN equals to have a representation, static Wegner representa alanu da un delega to be represented at the UN by a delegate, dynamic list voices found in various languages include, active voice agitative voice antipassive voice applicative voice causative voice circumstantial voice impersonal passive voice mediopassive voice medium voice equals middle voice neuter voice passive voice. Reciprocal voice subject and object perform the verbal action to each other, e.g. she and I cut each other's hair. Reflexive voice the subject and the object of the verb are the same, as in I see myself in the mirror. See also anticausative verb dative shift deponent verb description diathesis alternation English passive voice e prime grammatical conjugation morphosyntactic alignment unaccusative verb valency linguistics notes caret e.g. in Robert S. P. Beakey's Comparative Indo-European Linguistics. An Introduction 1995 Dionysus Thrax Techni Grammatica Art of Grammar Ig Peri Rematos 13 on the verb Diathesis Liddell, Henry George, Scott, Robert, A Greek-English Lexicon at the Perseus Project O'Grady, William, John Archibald, Mark Aronoff, and Jamie Rees Miller eds 2001 Contemporary Linguistics, An Introduction 4th Edition Boston, Bedard, St. Martin's ISBN 0-312-24738-9 AB The house is building. Why You Never Learned the Passival Tense, Even Though It Used to Be Proper English Grammar, by Mike Vuolo, Slate, May 29, 2012 A P for the Ages, January 13, 2011 Platt and Dennison, The Language of the Southey Coleridge Circle, Language Sciences 2000 Lee. Crioste M. H. Mack and Goyle Agus A. M. H. A. C. Teo.